On today's Town Hall agenda, we have shout-outs, important upcoming dates and reminders, and Light It Up Blue for Autism Awareness. Please stay tuned. Shout-outs. Shout-out to Ms. Matt for putting together today's Town Hall videos, and Ms. Oliveri for putting together the Flipgrid Circle Work activity for this week. We'll see more of that in just a little bit. Shout-out to everyone wearing blue today for your Meet and Zoom meetings as part of our Light It Up Blue for Autism Awareness Day. If you aren't currently wearing blue, you still have a chance to put on some blue and join us for our fifth period No One Eats Alone lunch, where we will be celebrating our Autism Awareness Day. And we'd like to wish a very special happy birthday to Jalen Best, Krista Davis, Jonathan Perul, Giovanni Jean, Jalen Nurse, Ms. Gito, Ms. Mapp, Mr. Moore, and Ms. Rowe, who all celebrated birthdays this week. Happy birthday, everyone. Here's some important upcoming dates that you should be aware of. Every Friday, fifth period, we have our No One Eats Alone lunch. Today, we are lighting it up blue. That link is posted in your grade-wide Google Classroom, so you can find the meet link in your class of 2021, 2022, or 2023 Google Classroom. The blended learning opt-in window has been extended to today. So if you are a fully remote student and your family would like you to come back into the building, today is the last day to complete that survey in order to opt back in for instruction in person learning. That's the last day for this school year. You can find that survey on the DOE's website, it's on the front page, or you can go to our BC website or PupilPath or your email to find the survey links that we've sent out. Next Tuesday, April 13th, is the third and final District 18 interim assessment for math. That test is taking place on Tuesday, April 13th. We will have an alternate schedule. The New York State Assessments opt-in deadline is also next Tuesday, April 13th. More on that in a minute. And state assessment season is starting April 19th. So that blended learning opt-in survey, it can be found online. It does close today. So once again, if you are a student who is fully remote and you would like to come back into the building, parents need to complete that survey today. We do not know when students who opt back in will return to in-person instruction. For those of you who have, we do not have a date for that yet. So please do not come to the building until you are told when we are ready. We have to reprogram and we have to get the clearance from the DOE first. Lastly, students who are remaining in a fully remote program, if you're already in one, or if you're currently in the blended learning program and coming to the building, you do not need to complete the survey. You don't need to do anything as long as you're staying with your learning preference. If you are coming back to the building, we remind you that parents or guardians must complete that survey, and that students, you must have a COVID-19 weekly testing consent on file. You can fill this out on OPERU or using the My Student NYC Schools account. If you have questions about that, you can please contact our main office and we will assist you with that. No student who is coming back to the building will be permitted to come into the building if you do not have that weekly testing consent on file. You will remain in fully remote learning if you don't have it on file. It's a must-have. Students who are enrolled in blended learning must also attend school in person Monday through Thursday. It is not optional to come in on some days and stay home on other days. It is not every other day anymore. It's Monday through Thursday and you're expected to be there. Students who do not attend school regularly for the in-person instruction will be moved to a fully remote program for the remainder of the year. A reminder that Saturday Academy resumes tomorrow. It's from 9 o'clock a.m. to 11 o'clock a.m. with a focus on assisting students with making up missing assignments and resolving annex codes. That link for that Saturday Academy Zoom is posted every Saturday in your grade-wide class of 2021, 2022, or 2023 Google Classroom. This is also very important for those of you who have annex codes to resolve. They're making plans for summer school. It's looking like we will have summer school, and students who do not earn these grades may have to make up this work during summer school. So if you have unresolved weekly portfolio tasks that you haven't done, if you have an annex code on a report card, please make sure that you are working with your teachers to make those up, and please attend Saturday Academy so that we can get you back on track. That way you don't end up in a situation where you are attending summer school this summer. As I mentioned before, the Math Matters Interim Assessment number 3 is being administered next Tuesday, April 13th. That's a school-wide assessment. We will be having an alternate schedule, which will be posted in your Google Classroom for the day. That day, we will have testing periods 1 through 3. That's when you will be completing the assessment. Those of you who are working remotely, you will be joining your teacher or a teacher online for those periods, so that way you can have somebody there to live proctor you. Obviously, if you're coming to the building, you'll just be taking the test periods 1 through 3. If you have any questions about the test, please do not hesitate to reach out to your math teacher and ask. Again, that schedule will be posted next week for you. New York State Assessments opt-in. So a letter was sent out with parents and guardians yesterday via email, PupilPath, and Remind regarding the New York State exams for ELA, mathematics, and science. Okay. These assessments will be administered this year. They are going to be administered in the building throughout windows in April, May, and June. April for the ELA assessment, May for the math assessment, and June for that 8th grade science assessment. You cannot complete these assessments remotely, so you must do them in person. Not every student is required to take these. In fact, you have to opt in to take these assessments. So if a parent or guardian wants you to sit for these assessments, they should complete the Google Form opt-in survey that was emailed out yesterday as part of that letter by next Tuesday, April 13th. That should say opt-in, not opt-in. That survey indicates that you want to sit for those exams. Please have a discussion with your families regarding this, if that's something you are interested in doing. They, again, need to complete that survey. If you do not do anything by April 13th, it is assumed that you are not taking these exams, and we will not plan for that. If your family does not wish for you to take the exam, you do not need to do anything. You just ignore the survey. All students, whether you are blended or remote, who are taking the assessments must do so in the building. So if you are a fully remote student and you are electing to take these exams, you are also electing to come to the building on the day that we say we are administering it for you. And so it's really important that you read that letter carefully and you make sure that you understand the procedures for the exam. There is also information within that letter about our protocols for in-person learning and for health screenings, so that way you are aware of the precautions that we take to ensure that we don't have any spread of COVID-19.
We are very excited to be celebrating Autism Awareness Day here at BC. We invite you to join us later for our BC No One Eats Alone Lunch, fifth period, via Meet, where we are going to be celebrating Autism Awareness and we are going to be lighting it up blue. So please join us and wear your blue. You can wear your blue BC swag if you got it. But if you don't, you can wear anything blue in honor of Autism Awareness. Before that, we're going to hear from Ms. Mapp, who's going to tell us a little bit more about autism and things we should know. And we're going to watch a short TED Talk from an amazing young gentleman named Cole Blakeaway, talking about his friend Steven and a little bit more about autism. So please stay tuned and enjoy.
Hi, guys. Welcome back to Town Hall. Today we are discussing autism and celebrating autism awareness. We are all different, and that's what makes us great. We all have brains, but not all of our brains think, process, and communicate the same, and that's okay. Our brains all process information differently, but for some, their brains are wired a bit differently, which affects their senses, how they perceive situations, or interaction with others. Some have difficulty with perspective taking, which means that they have difficulty looking at a situation from another person's point of view. Sometimes you might find that they don't even look at you and they don't have any eye contact, or unable to read your facial expression when you're explaining something. And this may cause a misunderstanding or conflicts in social situations with their peers. People with autism excel in many different ways that we may find difficult, like science, math, understanding numbers, remembering something from a long, long time ago, remembering quotes and fractions and things of that nature. We might find that difficult to do. However, things that we find easy, like saying hello or maintaining friendships or initiating friendships, they find that really difficult to do. Also, being able to express themselves and how they feel and what's going on in the moment, especially when they're feeling overwhelmed, they have difficulty doing that and expressing that. Everyone knows a person with autism. It could be your aunt, your cousin, your best friend, your neighbor, or even your doctor. Some people with autism have behaviors that may look a little unusual to you, such as rocking back and forth, flapping their arms, their hands, or even pacing the floor. No worries. These behaviors calm them when they're feeling overwhelmed and unable to cope with the situation going on in the moment. We all have behaviors that we use to cope. Some of us bite our nails, tap our feet, tap our thumbs, play with our hands, or listen to a favorite song. Remember, when you see these unusual behaviors to you, don't give them a hard time. Be a friend. Don't make fun of them or mock them. Just like you, they need support and they need people to understand where they're coming from and they need people to understand how they communicate. Remember, being different is amazing. So embrace the difference. On Friday, April 9th, we are highlighting autism awareness by wearing blue. Blue is the color that represents autism awareness. You want to support? Here's what you can do. On Friday, April 9th, you too can find something and wear it blue. And come to our Light Up Blue virtual lunch at 11:50 a.m. on Friday, April 9th. Also, you can submit a Flipgrid sent by Ms. Oliveri in your response to autism awareness. Don't forget, we are all different. So embrace the difference.
My name is Cole, and over the next few minutes, I'm going to teach you that it's okay to be different. Since a young age, I've worn different colored socks and two different shoes. Why? Because I am unique, a standout from the crowd. I feel best when I am being me. This summer, a funny thing happened. I was in a bookstore with my mom when I realized everyone was strangely quiet. And so I did what needed to be done. I started singing. As a joke, my mom pointed to a book and said, "Hey Cole, this book is for you." I pulled it out and read the cover. Here's what it said: "You're weird." A creative journal for misfits, oddballs, and anyone else who's uniquely awesome. It's the best book ever! It tells everyone it's cool to be different. Today, I'm going to tell you about a friendship of mine that is a little different than you might expect. This is one of my best friends, Steven. He is the happiest person I know. Steven is 44 years old and has autism. Let me start by explaining how we became special friends. When my mom was just 13 years old, she was in the high school cafeteria about to have lunch with her friends. Then she passed a table of kids with special needs. Steven was a boy at that table. He shouted out, "Hey, what's your name? Come sit with me." My mom sat down, and in that moment, a special friendship began. Steven asked my mom three questions. He wanted to know what she was having for lunch, her phone number, and if they could be friends for 40 years. As my mom gave him her phone number and said yes, he clapped with excitement and said, "I will call you every day." Ever since that day, in 1988, he has kept his promise and called our house every single day. When I was born, Stephen was a special part of our family, and I've grown up calling him Uncle Stephen. Steven is included in family dinners, he comes to my soccer games, he loves watching movies with us, and every couple of weeks he has a sleepover. Steven has had autism his whole life. Autism spectrum disorder refers to a range of conditions characterized by challenges with social skills, repetitive behaviors, speech and nonverbal communications, as well as by unique strengths and differences. My friend Steven is not able to drive a car, but he is able to memorize every phone number he has ever heard. There is no cure for autism, but I think Steven is perfect the way he is. One of my favorite memories with Steven is whenever a fire truck passes us. He shouts out, "When I grow up, I want to be a fire truck." That always makes me smile. He likes the idea of being a fireman, but he loves the idea of being a fire truck. Another thing that always makes me laugh is how much he likes to eat. Have you ever met someone who can eat a steak, 8 slices of pizza, French fries, apple pie, ice cream, and they are still starving? Well, Steven eats all that almost every time we see him. Finally, one of my favorite memories with Steven is when we play hide and seek. He always hides in the closets. I love playing hide and seek with Steven. It always makes me smile. But not just me. He makes everyone smile. I don't think we need a cure for autism, just like we don't need a cure for freckles. Autism is not a disease, just like brown hair isn't a disease. You don't need to fix something that isn't broken. I look up to my Uncle Steven, as he is the happiest person I know. Steven doesn't try to be like anyone else. He is exactly who he was meant to be. Imagine a world where we all live like Steven. Find out what makes you different. Don't be afraid to stand out. Wake up, jump out of bed, and be exactly who you are. We are all a little different, and that's awesome. Thank you.
And I want to say thank you to Miss Oliveri for putting together our Inner Superpower Flipgrid circle work this week. You can still contribute to that today if you'd like. You just go to your class of 2021, 2022, or 2023 Google Classroom and click on the circle work assignment, and you can complete that Inner Superpower Flipgrid. I also want to give a huge shout out and thank you to Miss Mapp for making the fantastic video for today's town hall and finding the other resources for us as well. Don't forget that Saturday Academy is taking place tomorrow. So students, if you have NX codes that you need to resolve or you need any assistance making up that work, please come to the Saturday Academy. The permission slip is in Opera Room. You can find the link for the Saturday Academy Zoom in the grade-wide Google Classroom. That's the class of 2021, 2022, or 2023 Google Classroom. Mr. Novin's also posted in the physical education classroom as well. That academy runs from 9 o'clock a.m. to 11 o'clock p.m., so please come by if you need any assistance making up your assignments. And lastly, I want to remind you that we have our BC No One Eats Alone lunch every Friday, fifth period. We want to invite you to join us for our today's Light It Up Blue for Autism Awareness lunch at 11:55 today. Again, you can find that meet link in your Google Classroom. Please join us. Please come. We have a good time. We'll be learning a little bit more about autism and having some trivia today. We hope to see you there. Bye. Oh, and have a great weekend. It's beautiful outside. Bye.